is please smash that subscribe button and like button. Nope. Fuck. Say thank you guys so much for all the love and everything like that, and all the people that come out to Quick Shot and... Nope. What's going on today, guys? Anthony here from Double Tap Media, and before we kick off this video, I do just want to say please smash that subscribe button and smash that like button. It helps out a lot, and I already appreciate everything you guys have been doing. Everybody that's already subscribed, everybody that watches it weekly whenever I make a video, and most importantly, anybody who ever hits me up in the comments on Instagram and Facebook and stuff like that, asking me questions, stuff like that. And a bunch of people have been asking me about Quick Shot in Shamong, New Jersey, and I tell them all the time, go there, find out, have fun, and get to play with me and all my friends, and you know, we just have the time of our lives. I am going to be starting a new segment, hopefully soon, where I bring my friends out to come play airsoft and we see how they do. But I'll stop rambling like an idiot. Let's get on to the video. What's going on today, guys? Anthony here from Double Tap Media, and today for review, we have my Lancer Tactical Gen 2 that I did do up with a bunch of 3D printing stuff, a lot of paint and stuff like that. So let's get into it. So guys, it is a beautiful fallish September day. Kids are outside playing. I'm outside pew-pewing, and the weather is gorgeous, and I just wanted to take advantage of it in my backyard like I have been doing. But let's get into the gun. So as you guys saw, I did paint my suppressor matte black, and I did do a textured finish on it, so it did look kind of realistic. You got your rail, your angled sight right here, which is, I have a 3D printed one, but I used my metal one for this video. I don't know why. My 3D printed vertical foregrip, which is hollow on the inside for more lightweight stuff like that, but it is durable and I do really like it. My red dot, a new Amiibo mag with a mag pull built in, I got from Quick Shot. This gun was purchased at Quick Shot for $130. You got your handle right here, obviously, and your really, really responsive, snappy electronic trigger, and your stock. The cool thing about the stock is you take this off and you take that off and your battery goes right there. This gun is LiPo ready and does have a MOSFET built in, so this is very cool. I'm sorry, this gun isn't 130. The base model is 130. The upgraded version with the electronic trigger and everything like that is 150. So $20 price difference is not that bad. And right here, you do have your Lancer Tactical logo and everything like that. And I did do a mag switch. This is the mag that came with the gun. I don't really like the tan. I do like the black accents and everything on it. That's why I did the hand grip and everything like that black. I am going to probably get a black stock for it, so that will look really nice. But this is the gun. And let's see how she shoots. Now, the mag that it comes with is your typical 300 round high cap with the dial on the bottom. I really don't like high caps. It takes the realism out of the gun. So I did get this mag with a little mag pull. It's a 150 round mid cap, which I do really like. I do have to get another one of these. But that was the gun in semi and full automatic. The gun, I read, does shoot between 350 and 400 FPS. And that's with .2s. I do use .28. BBs, so I will see on the chrono. Whoop, I will see on the chrono how that does shoot on Sunday when I am at Quick Shot. But that was the Lancer Tactical. I do love the gun a lot, and for the price point, I couldn't beat it. It outbeat my M4, and I sold my M4 to get this gun, my Valken M4. But if you guys do want to see that review of the lost gun, the link will be down below to that gun. But in comparison, this does beat it, but as you guys already know, I do love my ARP9. But No cons on the gun, all pros, looks, functionality, stuff like that. This gun does come with a battery and a charger, so that is a plus. It comes with an unchecked battery. I believe it is a 1600 milliamp nunchuck Tamiya battery, but like I did say, it does have the MOSFET and everything in it, so the gun's a good gun for the price point, 150 bucks. The ARP9's priced at 250 or 240 depending on where you go, so that is a $100 price difference, and you do get a really, really good gun. But before we wrap up the video, if you guys do want anything 3D printed and you guys don't have a 3D printer, please hit me in the comments down below, or go see me on the Instagram. That will be down below in the description. But guys, I hope you like this video, and I will see you in the next one, or I'll see you guys at the field.